My last blood sugar test was so-so. You can even say it sucked. With all my dietary changes and physical activity, kind of hope for better, but it still hangs around where it was last year during my 60-day berberine experiment. So when I got the test result, I got myself 2 months' supply of Akkermansia, this new generation probiotic, which was never possible before, like just because of the technology. It's produced in oxygen-free environment, which is kind of cool. It's getting popular in the longevity community, probably thanks to Peter Attia.
Let's explain what Akkermansia does to control glucose. You've alluded to this a couple of times now. Do we have an insight into why Akkermansia is something that lowers an individual's blood glucose or response to a glucose load?
At a very fundamental level, this is primarily through the GLP-1 pathway.
And just to get people excited about that, if you're hearing this and you've heard of Ozempic, you've heard of GLP-1.
So right now I'm almost at the end of my second bottle, and it's a time to get myself plugged with another CGM. It's going to give us some information on how I'm doing for a few days on probiotics, and then for about 10 days without any probiotics, sort of tapering off. And, oh, buggers. They stopped putting a wipe in here. Archie bastards, give me a second. All right, here we go. Some wipes. Because the last thing you want to do is to get some infection with a needle when you plug yourself. What makes my situation, I don't know, unique or maybe not so unique? I was treated with azithromycin for several months to treat Lyme disease and Bartonella. Kind of after meeting with some unpleasant tick. And that azithromycin is like a nuclear blast. What do I do with that? Hold on a second. I see the needle. Yeah, it looks, it does look scary, but you know, it's not that bad. So as I was saying, I was on azithromycin for several months, which gave me some dysbiosis after that. And I was slowly improving through the years with some rosacea and some gut discomfort, which actually got better in the last months as I was using that, but maybe because it's winter time right now, it's a little drier around, so it can be just a coincidence. And this way I'm going to get hopefully more objective data. I don't expect too much, to be honest, but I wasn't expecting much from berberine either, and I was totally blown away. So I guess, oh, we'll see. Well, I'm kidding, it wasn't that painful. Ta-da! So the one little trick, I'm not going to activate it right away because those CGMs, they have a tendency not to settle very well for like a day or two. I'm going to sleep on it, let it settle, kind of rest, and then I'm going to activate it and we'll start the experiment.
Something strange going on. Pretty much the day I stopped taking Akkermansia, my sleep quality just tanked. Maybe coincidence? It's slowly getting up. Well, I hope it gets to normal range when we retest. Well, anyway, let's go and talk some science.
2 days later, and the sensor has fully settled. I even had a spike in body temperature during the first night. Now it's back to normal, and it's time to activate it. Ta-da-da! Sensor is going to be ready soon. So let's talk about Akkermansia in general. What does it do and what kind of side effects it might have? Because, well, there are some. Akkermansia shown a lot of promise in the animal models as an intervention. And if I just go and read everything, it sounds quite amazing. It improves metabolic health, reduces body weight, improves glucose tolerance and insulin sensitivity, improves gut health, reduces inflammation, improves liver health, improves cardiovascular health, even helps with cancer and ALS and Alzheimer. But the problem is, it's all in animal models, and human studies are still limited or just ongoing. So some caution is warranted. And speaking about caution, Akkermansia works by scraping the mucin from the walls of the gut. And after that scraping, it's supposed to grow bigger and stronger. But for that to happen, you need plenty of dietary fiber. So the way it works, Akkermansia plus fiber produces good results. Akkermansia without fiber actually degrades the mucin and make your gut leakier. So if you are going to try it, if you're going to try Akkermansia, make sure that you get at least plenty of fiber and that you start small and see how you react. Make sense? And sensor is going to be ready soon. Tomorrow we're going to take a look at my fasting glucose and going to do a few tests. So normally I would start my day by eating some greens, eggs, a little bit of salmon, but today I'm going to do the load test. So I just had my Akkermansia and I'm going to make some morning exercises and make myself prepare some coffee and we'll see. So for the reference, yesterday was my resistance training day. And I had pretty good night's sleep. Let's see. Yeah, and readiness is in 80s. Sleep is in 80s, which is all important when you look for the glucose numbers. And currently, I'm dangling around 95. Which is okay. Better than 105. And so I have my coffee, nut milk. And this load test is pretty much overnight oats with 3 extra spoons of collagen powder, 1 spoon of creatine, psyllium husk, and all the usual stuff. Oh, plus a little bit of raspberries. It's amazing. Almost like a dessert. Right, I'll see you in an hour. Also wanted to to add that to eat that much protein and fiber is not that easy. Okay, it's about 1 hour later, a little more. I got a little carried away and missed the highest point, which was about 120. So I got 25-30 points bump in the glucose, which is not bad, and it went down as it should. So overall, actually, I'm pretty happy with the results. Of course, the question is, how is it going to behave later on when I'm off Akkermansia for a week and we'll do the similar test. Maybe I'm going to repeat the same tomorrow, day after tomorrow, just to get better average. But that's kind of typical, so we'll see. All right, and just like that, it's the last day. Time flies fast, that's probably the most surprising thing. So yesterday was the same resistance training day for me. And my sugar is trailing nicely, around 90. Sleep is at 88, which is pretty great. Readiness as well, pretty good, so hopefully more or less everything is the same. And it's time to make some coffee and get some testing done. A little bit of lion's mane into my coffee. I did an experiment with it too some time ago. Some coffee into my coffee. Little bit of nut milk, freshly made. I'll see you in an hour. And just like that, glucose is going down. Nothing really special happened. The jump was about 15-20 points. It's almost like it's a null experiment, or I can probably say that off Akkermansia, I'm doing somewhat better. My night glucose became better slightly. My daily glucose is better. The challenge is slightly better. It's all within the measurement error. I'm not even sure if we should pause this video. Well, I guess if you see it, I decided to post. Sometimes you need to see some null experiments as well. You know, it's not always, whoa, such a big amazing change happened. Sometimes you just, you don't know. So what are the conclusions, at least for me? It's very promising probiotic. I would definitely use it if I would be on antibiotics which affect Akkermansia. Otherwise, it's kind of hard to justify the cost without any significant observations you can do for yourself. I mean, I wish I could try the more expensive version, glucose control, but it's like $100 plus per bottle. Maybe one day when my longevity startup gets off the ground, I could afford that, but definitely not now without any clear indications of how to measure the results anyway. Sometimes it's just like that. My average glucose is still hanging. It's like glucose control, almost like A1C, but for real. Around 5.4, which is above what I would like to see. Maybe because I don't have enough muscle mass. And it's, so my next heavy gun to try is enclomiphene. I'm going to be 50 soon, so it's something to get myself on. Get on gear. But if you want to see something impressive, go check out my berberine experiment. It's definitely not an null experiment, it's a wow, holy shit experiment. Aging is bad, living is smart, and I'll see you there.